What?
Zone definitely had some issues around that. Speaking of aggression.
Yeah, in a whole lot of trouble. There's the corrosive charge, and Rascal able to get the last auto attack. Can he get in there? No, he can't. The flash away from Smeb. Lots of vision here around the top side of the map as well, which is exactly where they want it. Given the fact that Smeb is the one without a flash. There's the flash into Stain. There to bring Smeb further back into the lane, and I have a feeling he's not going anywhere, cuz picks up his axe, and he's going to continue slowing down this Sion. He'll be able to take care of some minions, but that is first blood going to Kingzone in the first. The KT is
missed out. Quarterback for moments like this. Ash should be the winner here, but Pawn is pretty overextended.
Yeah, BDD gonna easily be able to pick this one up. Zonyas is gonna go down, but there is nowhere that Pawn is going. Flashes actually and has the heal, but a few extra
bot side Smeb. He didn't go Iceborne Gauntlet, so pretty painful his lane.
Yep. Does at least have his first item, so that is good news, but this ain't. There's the disdain. Rascal underneath the turret wants to land the ultimate. Hasn't used it just yet. Oh, and that's a really good stopwatch use. Won't have it.
Right now. It's going to be risky. They're trying it.
Yep. In goes the train as Tucson's going to block it. Tries to use the Unbreakable there as Pawn has to flash very early in this fight. BDD already exhausted as Tucson flashes away in depth. Way too far away. Doesn't even land the arrow as it just sails by majestically. Knock up there onto Rascal. He's just going to get booped around, but no last breath.
And he will be outcome. Pretty reliably here. Rascal walks up. This could be a mistake.
Yeah, he's going to get hooked there as well into the box. Trouble Bubble comes down and he has to use his stopwatch, but no one is close enough. The flash is going to be utilized to disdain, and the heal's going to keep him alive. And now Cuz finds himself right in the middle of the thick of it. Has to flash to get his way out.
Oh,
in fact,
hits.
Everyone is flashing. Tucson is going to be the one that has the most trouble, but Stand Beside Me is off cooldown. Party cast going to come in. That's Smeb with a three-man knock-up, but they're just putting the right people forward. Arrow is going to land. The slows are good, but another hook is going to come in, and Gango grabs the first kill of this very extended fight. Pawn does have the stopwatch, but it's not enough. Zonya's Hourglass now on cooldown, but his life is forfeit, and BDD still looking for more. Kingzone just botching it.
And that's Kingzone returning to Kesper Cup, where they had good early games and then started to make mistakes. Kingzone pushing out.
In trouble, walks around the wind wall this time. They get the Glacial Fissure, but into the back line. That's the three-man knock-up. So much damage comes in as BDD just locks them all away. Pawn decimated, and KT get that.
Obvious team-wide knock-ups it was the start of the party. But it's all about BDD closing. He's not jumping for glee.
I think Scorn may have landed a barrel.
Let's watch the replay here so they know. W's on cooldown to start,
no,
it was Smeb at the back there that opens it up. Two people die instantly. This is pre-IE, this is pre the ecstasy on the side of BDD, but it gets KT the Baron, and Kingzone Dragon X's first mistake is compounded because remember, in this fight, no summoners, no flashes to flash away from the knockup. Watching the replay here, it's on to Tucson and Dev. Tucson joins the party, Urgot as well. If you have your summoners, you're not hit by that knockup. But the knockup ends the story for the side of
them. They'll take their first dragon after taking down that Baron. And what it does is, you know, BDD may not have that Infinity Edge, but he holds it in the air.
Kingzone Dragon X might have actually been a different match. It was in the Worlds qualifiers where basically every Yasuo Q was flashed away from, every knockup was flashed away from. You need your flash to get away from the synergy.
Free hitting here on the top side. I think the ultimate
Smeb's
didn't
dead.
Actually land there, but Smeb is going to go down. Zombie Sion.
They're starting onto the Baron. They've got a lot of vision in this area. I think KT have to react.
Yep, Score running pretty damn quickly as now the train has left the station. In he goes as BDD gets exhausted to begin this one. Kingzone haven't actually offered too much back here as Disdain is used, but Rascal's still going to get taken down. And now Tucson running for the hill step, trying to get the auto attacks down, but Gango flashes on top of him. It's a double kill for BDD as the Lantern Ride is going to continue the party. Pawn's going to go down. It's the Guardian Angel for BDD. So much of his health comes back. And now look at the bottom lane. Kingzone's bottom lane, in a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen, just waiting to die at the end of the fight, and Deft is going to get crushed by Smeb's foreman. death timer not too long either.
Let's watch it. It is five members of KT.
Yeah, they've got a lot of damage as well. You can see that tower just evaporated as now Gango trying to get the damage across. Cuz is going to fall down and Rascal should be soon to follow. Does go into the grinder. There's the four-man fear at the same time. Tucson doesn't quite land the ultimate, but Gango has to go so far to get on top of that lantern. He's still burning down. Last tick, not enough. And Kingzone will be able to defend their base. Smeb will eventually go down. Teleport here from Deft actually towards the top side as they're trying to get more back. And there we go. We've seen so many times. Doesn't matter how far behind they are.
No three-lane pressure from KT allows Kingzone to make this 5v5. It's here, Smeb.
Yeah, the train does come in now. It's going to land onto just Rascal, but that's not the target they want. Once again, Tucson throws his ultimate into a wind wall. That is not what you want, and KT still are so incredibly healthy. Pawn portal jumping to try and get himself around, but they do decide just to take down the Urgot with the last breath. Gango in trouble as the Paddle Stars come through, and Kingzone are still in amongst this fight. The flash through from Pawn, but he's unable to connect onto Gango in the backline. Snowflower in trouble, and now it's the Ash who has to deal with all of the low health members, but they're finally falling. The damage is still here, and Dev picks up two. One goes over to Pawn, who's now having a field day. Gango is in vision, and BDD, yeah, does use the cleanse to get himself out of the way, and now they have to go for this 2v2. It's mid laner and AD for both sides. And there's the wind wall. That could be the trouble now as BDD's playing nicely.
He's in again!
But does have another ultimate, but Def gets the cheeky auto, and Gango now finds himself 1v2 and trying to get rid of these minion waves. This game is so incredibly close. It's been crazy, it's been weird, but damn, it's been exciting as Gango finally goes down, and that's the ace for Kingzone.
Unbelievable. Kingzone able to win this against this team fight, and a lot of it is because of poke at the start, getting Gango low. Smeb comes in, no last breath yet. Like you say, Tucson's ult is wasted, but Rascal, obscenely tanky as we know. He's still buying time, he's still finding positioning, and notice where Deft and Pawn are. They're over a wall, no damage coming onto them from KT. So in the back line, the poke onto Gango is very relevant
that
here.
That one paddle star was so important as well.
Pawn can't get an assassination, but low health bars when they finally get the first target. Notice that there was so low threat onto Deft, he cleanses and then is hitting multiple people. It's Prey it. Whoa, it's all over again.
Yeah.
The ability to frontline here. So all the beef was sacrificed from KT just to gap close and get the damage in. And by the end, Gango's out of the fight and BDD can't fight 1v2. Don't tell him that. He tried real damn hard.
Yeah, Pawn unfortunately unable to find the paddle star as BDD sort of surprised him there. The last breath looked damn cool, but Deft still had his Guardian Angel and everything. He wasn't going to go down there as Kingzone. See some relief on Acorn's face, but not enough. The anxiety.
Both for their seasons and against their old orgs for these players to pop off.
Yep, Troll Global not going to land. The arrow does hit, though. His score might get picked off. The autos are there, and Tucson is the one that secures it. Kingzone, they finally found their pick and now want to take down the base.
Dead time is a minute. What else can they get here? Can they just try to end? KT will have to all in to stop it.
Yep, the Culling's going to come in, but that's not going to kill any of these minions as he has to get himself the hell out of there, cuz still throwing the undertows through, and look at the damage onto these structures.
They're gonna have to try something now.
Yep, Nexus turrets are gonna be the next to go down, as Smeb has such a huge health bar, but who damn cares? A Snowflower lands the Q, but it's just not enough. The last breath is onto three members, but he's just gonna get blown up. Rascal flashing forward, in goes Cuz, as well as Gango gets soloed out by the jungler, and I don't know how it happened, but Kingzone came back from the brink, came back from a Nexus under fire and two inhibitors down. And win game one.
Kingzone in the clutch, get it done, but oh, was it close against KT Rose. They thought they'd had it. They rushed at that Nexus, but the Nexus doesn't go down, and then Kingzone, two different skirmishes in a row, outplay KT Rolster and find the game one victory. The action in this series is levels above what we could have expected, and both these teams desperate for their first match win.
And you could feel that desperation in how that game played out as well. I was on the edge of my seat throughout the entire thing, watching Kingzone finally find the pick that they were looking for. It took them 40-odd minutes to get there, but once it happened, the game was over.
And it was nice to see Deft deliver on what we remember. That was some EDG.
If only we could travel back in time. Whoa.
Right where we belong. Maybe we'll never need a reason why. Whoa. Dancing till the time.
If only we could travel back in time.
and dance until the time.